I'm Shane White, and this is The Process.
Hey gang, Shane White here with a much longer episode of The Process. This is a cover for my Braun graphic novel, a project I'm currently kickstarting. Please check out the link in the description box below to pledge or pass along to those who love sci-fi graphic novels about girls, robots, and total destruction. On to the work. Here I'm using all the regular standbys: kneaded eraser, Ticonderoga HB pencils, my first Raphael 8404 number 2 sample brush, a broken Winsor & Newton Series 7 number 2 brush, and a not so broken Series 7 number 2 brush, as well as Speedball Super Black ink on a 90 pound Wausau paper. Right out of the gate, I stretch and roll the kneaded eraser. This picks up the graphite, giving my ink a chance to stick better to the paper. Roll and stretch until it's at least 50% lighter. Pro tip, never, ever break in a new brush on a large piece. Heck, on any piece you want to turn out right. I thought I was being a real manly artist, and boy, did I fight with it. Work your brushes for a little bit. Ink drawings in your sketchbooks, on scrap paper. Find out the character of the brush, because no two are alike. So I picked up this paper on a lark at a paper store 8 years ago when there used to be paper stores. Anyway, suffice it to say, for $30, I got 250 sheets of 11 by 17, which was about the same thickness as 2-ply Bristol used in making comics. The first thing I noticed is it's super bright white. It takes pencil really well. I can print drawings in non-reproducible blue ink, and for the most part, it takes ink rather well. For the most part. It's a thirsty paper. What that means is the sizing in the paper, which all paper has, to prevent ink from bleeding into a hot mess, is considerably thick. The sizing is like starch, and it just sucks the ink right out of the brush, causing strokes to seem shorter because it dries out faster. It works just fine for commissions. It's a good quality paper that doesn't yellow like Bristol, and the bright white makes the clients happy. The black seems bold because the ink stands out better. While I personally like working on a smooth plate surface, 2-ply Strathmore 500 series Bristol, yeah, if you can say that 5 times fast, sometimes you have to look at opportunity costs. If you're doing a cover or a one-off piece, ask yourself, what kind of experience do I want to have? Find out the limits of the materials and see what makes sense. For instance, the less expensive board does not take quill at all. It's terrible. So keep these things in mind. I have a key ring of paper with notes on it saying what the paper is and what it's good for, because oftentimes it's just too easy to forget. Thank you. So this is my first example of a double page spread for you guys. Actually, it's a wraparound cover where I taped two sheets of Bristol together after much measuring and figuring for bleed areas. A bleed area is 1/4 inch thickness all the way around the image that will eventually get cut off in the printing process. So you want to add that if you're doing any type of illustration where the art goes right up to the edge. I say 1/4 inch. Some people use 1/8 inch. It just depends on the printer. Now that many artists have the control of the final scan and layout of the finished page, it's nice to give yourself some room to push and pull to get it to fit. This cover in particular is difficult because the star on the large version of Braun actually has to line up with the logo for the book. I wanted to make sure it didn't fight with the logo, something I didn't account for when I designed both he and the logo.
What about the forests?
Nope.
Logos are brands that should hold the eye and give the audience a sense of what it is. At least that's what I learned when I worked at a design firm many years ago. I've always loved logo types and lettering. When I was a kid in grade school, I was tasked with helping my classmates get better at creating their letter forms. Man, did they hate me after that. It's been a downhill race to the bottom ever since. Thank you. Composing a complicated scene has always been something I've gotten myself into. I'm not sure why. I get sucked into the detail, but that in itself can be very seductive to a fault. Here's the way I went about it. With so many options to create the perfect cover, I knew I wanted to hit a few criteria. I wanted it to speak to what the themes of the story were. Robots, girls, fighting. Done. I also wanted to make it clear with all that detail that the hero of the book is a very dutiful robot, Maven's guardian, Braun. Braun created my mid-ground shape to help hold the foreground together without adding any more detail. His chest light worked well to keep the focus on the important character silhouettes. Deca City in the background is like an establishing shot. It's the background for the story as well as for the image. I love architecture, just for the fact that it sets off very organic forms. Could I have done without the city? Possibly. But the large building on the back cover is Axiom Global, the antagonist of the book. With governing corporations called politicors, I thought a faceless enemy to start would build up the intrigue to the person behind the curtain. We'll see. So, three big shapes, foreground shape, middle ground shape, and background shape. You can push and pull with warm and cool color choices, color saturation, line thicknesses, and spotting of blacks, but keeping the plane separate and clear is important to sell the composition. More so, keeping what you want your audience to focus on is above all else your goal.
everywhere, and the next would be like a huge river with white sandy beaches, clear turquoise water.
You know, in the 60s and 70s, that's how it worked. You know, there was one guy, and things changed very much. So, no, it couldn't happen.
Honestly, I don't trust myself as a clever designer to do an austere cover with simple shapes and lots of negative space. I mean, it was never that kind of book to begin with. At its heart, it's always been about the characters and storytelling. Nothing stoic, nothing elite, just easy access storytelling with twists and turns. So after years of literally hundreds of cover designs, this is where I landed. It's almost embarrassing how long it took, but in the end, at least I'm not ashamed of it. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something new that you can add to your own toolkit. Again, please consider supporting the Kickstarter so I can send you this 170-plus page book loaded with extras. As always, thanks for watching.